Good afternoon. God bless you all. Thank God for another day. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Today is the first Sunday of February. The Lord has kept us alive and well. I'm so grateful to Him. Thank you, and God bless you. For as many who will be coming and those who are on their way, God bless you. And good morning to you, everyone. Good afternoon, good evening, whichever time that is applicable for you. Today, I am so glad to bring my live broadcast. Today, I have a topic that I have want to talk about today. It's about why couples need to be friends. Why couples need to be friends? Couples, why do you have to be friends? How important is it for you to be friends? Or can you just be living together in the home as two individuals that have chosen to come together and have children? Is that how you want your home to be? We'll find out what it is or how God expects us to live together as couples. The Bible said He created Adam, and then He said it wasn't good that Adam should be alone. He was going to make a helpmeet for Adam. He brought Eve to become companion with him. He wanted both of them to be companions, to be friends, to help each other, to be useful to each other. So husband and wife that are living together today, you don't just have to live in the same house as individuals living in the home. This one is going his way, that one is going their way. No, you have to be friends. Today we will talk about why you were growing up. Hope you had friends. How did you relate with your friends? How were you getting on with your friends? And somebody who is your friend, how do you treat him? How do you behave with somebody you appreciate in your life? There will be some of the things that we'll be talking about today. Friendship is a choice. You have made a choice. This is who will be my friend. Right now, we are now adults. Thank you so much, everyone that will be coming this afternoon. Friendship is a choice. And when you make a choice of a husband or for a wife, you made it deliberately. It's a choice that you have made. And now that you have made the choice, though, when both of you come together, there are some things that you will find out that too many different things, and then you are trying to make adjustments. Praise the Lord. You have chosen your spouse, you have chosen your husband, and you have chosen your wife. And then you have to be friends to make things working and make things good, make things right, continually, every day. So I have written down a few things. God had a friend. And who was God's friend? It was Abraham. The Bible says that God will not do anything without telling Abraham, his friend. Even when he was going to destroy the land of Sodom and Gomorrah, he had to take permission from Abraham. And Abraham would not let him do it. And you saw how, because Abraham was a friend of God, Lot, who was his nephew, was not consumed with the people of Sodom and Gomorrah. That's how it is when you are friends together. You and your husband, you are friends. You are not just two people living together. A man and a wife living together and then just trying to let ends meet. No. You are friends that take discussions together, do things together. The way you used to relate with your friend when you were in the university, when you were in secondary school, you want to stay around your friends, you want to be with your friends. You know how you used to do it. That's how you have to be with your husband, with your wife. Because when you are friends with your husband, when you are friends with your wife, you people are able to resolve conflicts easily. An outsider cannot come. Praise the Lord. I want to first establish who you are in Christ. It's in 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 9. We are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who had called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Praise the Lord. That is who you are. Get that clear, that you are a priest. You are a royal. You are a peculiar person chosen by God. You are not just one person wandering on the streets. A very special person to God. And if you are a special person to God, God loves you. And you love God. And God can do anything with you because God loves you. God can make something beautiful. Thank you everyone for coming. I'm so glad that you are here. God bless you so much. I appreciate your presence. Let's come together. If you can invite your friends so that they can hear in the teachings as well. You are a special person. God can do anything with you. You are not just one person wandering around in the streets. A royal. It was when I traveled to the Western world, I know how the royals are being treated. The royals are royal. The Bible says that's who you are. You are not just one person wandering on the streets. Praise the Lord. If you are a royal person, you are married to that man, you are married to that woman, how do you treat a royal person? Do you want to give up your friendship with a royal person? No. If you know that your husband is going to be attending the G20 meeting in 6 months' time, how would you treat him? I don't know if everybody knows what is G20. G20 are the top 20 nations to have a meeting to decide what will be happening in the nations. Or you know that your husband will be attending G7. The G7 is the 7 top nations. How will you treat your husband? How will you treat your wife? If you know that he will be attending that meeting, she will be attending that meeting, will you not secure your friendship with him? Will you not protect your relationship with her? You will not treat her like anyhow. You know that she's a special person. You know that he's a special person. There will be the right words you will speak to him. There will be the right words you will speak to her. Even when opportunity comes for maybe to speak the harsh words, maybe he has even wronged you, she has wronged you, you want to say the harsh words. When you consider that in the next 3 months, this is the position you will be, would you not mind what you say? You will not just talk anyhow. But because you don't see anything like that, you just feel like, I don't mind him. I don't mind her. She's a no good person. This woman, she's not good. She's good for nothing. This man, he's good for nothing. But you cannot see the plan of God. That's why you are treating that person like that. If you see the plan of God, there's a way you will treat him. There's a way you will treat her. That man that you are looking like that, do you know that? That man is somebody's prayer request. It's somebody's prayer point. And that woman you are looking like that, she's also somebody's prayer point. Don't treat him like trash. Don't treat her like trash. If you see the investment that God has put in that man, that God has put in that woman, boy, you will be careful how you treat your friendship with him. Imagine you know that in 3 weeks' time, things will change for your husband. And then he will tell you, okay, baby, honey, whichever one he calls you, I'm going to buy you that latest car. Would you not mind what you say to him? Even when he tells you, do like this, you say, okay, I will do it. That's how you are supposed to relate on a daily basis. On a daily basis. And do you know that when you do that, the gift of God on his inside continues to find expressions, continues to find expression. His best is coming out. His best is coming out. And when you treat that woman like a princess, like, for instance, you think, you now know that in a few weeks' time, she's going to have a contract that will be bringing income like this, that will be bringing income, for instance, thousands of pounds. How will you treat her? Nobody will come in between the two of you. But because we don't see any of these things, we take each other for granted. We despise each other. That's not the way it ought to be. Value him. Value her. Her best will be finding expression every day. His best will be finding expression. We don't value what we have. We think that he's not good enough because he has done a wrong thing. Yes, he may have done a wrong thing. Maybe his state of his heart, you did not see it. You didn't know why he did it. I have an illustration to make. There was one time when I just newly came here. Thank you everyone for coming. God bless you. If you can invite your friends, share it with your friends. God bless you. There was something that was going to cause quarrel between me and my husband. Sorry, I will be using myself sometimes. And what would have caused the quarrel? He just said it. He did not really notice that he even said it. And then when he said it, I was just looking at him. I was quiet. But in my heart, I was just thinking, why is he talking like this? But I just kept quiet. I did not really respond. But in my heart, I was just wondering why he should have spoken like that. Do you know that very few days ago, he was the one, something that would have brought quarrel. Few days ago, he was the one, unknowingly, he was just talking about it in a very different form. Imagine I had quarreled at that time, and then the quarrel lasted for 2 or 1 week. Was there any point to go that far? No. If you value your husband, if you value your wife, well, every day he will keep knowing what to do. She will keep knowing what to do. You value each other. You appreciate each other. The best continues to find expression. The hidden treasure that God has put in him, that God has put in her, will be coming out. Do you know what it is when your husband knows that you love him? Do you know what it is when your wife knows that you love him? When somebody knows that I am loved, ooh, they are always happy. They know that when I get home, there's a woman that loves me. There's a husband that loves me. They are so relaxed. They are so confident of themselves. God bless you, everyone. Love your husband because the best of him is coming gradually. Don't despise him. Do you know that I saw one place in the Bible where even the mother of Jesus, he did not know Jesus at the time. She addressed Jesus as a gardener. Some of us, that's the way we address our husbands. That's the way we address our wives. You are not seeing the glory of God in the inside of that woman. You are not seeing the glory of God on the inside of that man. That's why you are addressing him like that. Let's go there quickly. John chapter 19 and verse 15. You will see how Mary addressed Jesus, his son. He did not know him. John chapter 19 and verse 15. Okay, let me read it. Let me find it from my book. Okay, John 20 and verse 15. It says, and Jesus said unto her, woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be the gardener, saith unto him, sir, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Mary, the mother of Jesus, after Jesus was risen from the grave, you know, Jesus kept showing himself to the people, to his disciples. On one occasion, Jesus came, Thomas wasn't there. Thomas said, no, I don't believe until I see where they really pierced him. When I see those nails, I see his side that, okay, he's actually risen before I believe that. Okay, he's actually risen. On one day when Mary went to the grave, when Jesus was no longer in the grave, Jesus was standing by, looking. Mary was asking Jesus. He addressed Jesus as the gardener and said, please, if you know where he is, tell me. Let me take him away. Jesus, Mary did not know it was Jesus. If you know the gift and the grace of God upon your husband, if you know the gift and the grace of God upon your wife, don't you know how much you will address her? Don't you know how much respect you were addressing? A woman wants to be loved. A man wants to be respected. Imagine your husband is going to be the next prime minister. Women, we know how it is now. You know how you will behave yourself because I am going to be the first lady. Is there any woman who don't want to be the first lady? But do you know that you're already a first lady in his life? You're already a first lady. Or your husband is not going to be the CEO of one big team. You will respect him. But you don't need to see that first before you do it, my brother. You don't need to see that first before you do it, my sister. Let it be a usual occurrence in your home. Let it be the norm in your family. If you behave like friends, do you know one of the advantages? Your children will also grow up to be friends. Sibling rivalry will be eliminated. They will love themselves. Wife, respect your husband. Husband, love your wife. Treat her like a jewel. Treat him like, you know that egg, when it falls down, it's gone. Praise the Lord. There are some people today, they are wishing their husband was still there. Have you not seen a young woman who has lost her husband? And then you see the way she wails. And then when situation happens, you say, oh, I wish she was here. And then you see some of the men and say, oh, I wish she was here. But you that you have your own now, you don't seem to call it a deal. You don't seem to appreciate the investment. Appreciate this investment that God has given to you. It's the best thing you can do for yourself. Your children will grow up seeing a very good environment, a lovely environment, an environment to raise children. The children will be whole. Have you not seen children who have been intimidated? They are children. It's the environment in which they grew up from. Those are some of the things that has influenced them to be like that. Couples, you need to be friends. I want to give an example of one time I went to do a training. This woman, she kept making mention of, my husband bought me a car when I got 50. My husband bought me a car when I got 50. My husband bought me a car. You know, there was always a situation where she would make mention of it. But you know what this woman said? She said when they first got married, they had their first child when they were young. When they got married, she said they were always quarreling. They were always quarreling, fighting all the time. And there was a little child in the house. They were fortunate enough, but their both parents were here. And then the parents knew that they were always quarreling and fighting. You know what they did? They took the child from them and then they said, the two of you, you must stay inside the house. If you want to quarrel, stay in the house. Whatever you want to do, do it and be inside. This couple, when they were quarreling, they were in the house. They were in love, they were in the house. They were cooking. The child was now with the grandparents. Do you know that they now got so used to each other that it's now become on a daily basis for them. He said they must stay a minimum of 1 hour every day together. They must stay. The children now know. The children are grown now. They now know that daddy and mommy, they stay together every day, 1 hour. Actually, I was trying to ask her, how are you able to do it every day? She said, yes, they create time for it. your husband likes this. If you know who he is, you even if you don't like it, you will adjust yourself to like it for him. I was reading a book just now that's by Covenant Marriage. And then the man was trying to explain the differences in couples. The couples went out on a date. The woman chose a cheap menu. They went to a restaurant to eat something. The woman chose a cheap menu. And then the man felt slighted, like, why are you choosing a cheap menu? Choose something good that I know is expensive. You know what their response was? The woman said, I thought I was going to save more money. When I choose that, we'll be able to have money for other things. But do you know what the response of the man was? The response of the man was, I feel like when you choose something cheap, it appears like I'm a failure. I can't take care of what you want. These are because they are friends. They talk to each other. They talk inner things together. The man would have kept quiet and said, okay, that's what she wants. The woman would have said, okay, let me just do whatever. But they were open to each other. They are talking to each other. My friends and family, let your husband be your friend. Let your wife be your friend. Even the children you have now, for those who have been married 10 years, 15 years, 25 years, your children now, they have left the house. For those whose children are still young, give yourself another 15 years. Your children will not be there. Is this husband that you will have? Is this wife that you will have? So you need to build friendship today. Do you know that when you are friends, in-laws cannot interfere in your marriage? The husband wants to make the wife happy. The wife wants to make the husband happy. All these stories of mother-in-law, father-in-law, sister-in-law, there will not be stories like that. Because you have so built a bond that a third party cannot come in between the two of you. You are not friends. You don't talk about things. You just, this one is looking for money, that one is looking for this, that one is this. You have to be friends. You know when you first said you were going to marry her, when you were going to marry him, how you guys used to do it. You have to return back to that stage, that time. You have to be friends. It will solve conflicts. It will resolve financial crisis. It will build your home. You will work together. Anything you both agree to do together, you will get there. Praise the Lord. I'm so glad that you are here. And for as many who will be listening after this time, husband and wife, be friends with your wife. Be friends with your husband. I so appreciate your presence. God bless you. Make him your friend. Make her your friend. She will keep expressing, you know, there's the hidden part of God that nobody has seen. She will bring it out. He will bring it out. You will be enjoying yourselves. Divorce will be very far. Those stories of divorce, it will not be mentioned amongst us anymore. Children will be growing well. Thank you so much, everyone. Children will be growing happy. Because a lot of us children today, there are some things we are suffering because of the foundation we have. And then we are trying to break out. We must break out indeed. Husband, wife, be friends indeed. Don't act like Mary, who addressed Jesus like a gardener because he didn't know her. Your husband is loaded. Your wife is loaded, even though you are not seeing it. Praise the Lord. I wrote a few things down. You don't want to let your friend go because there's something in him or in her. If you have a friend, for instance, that you know that in 3 weeks' time, you have not flown in a plane, you'll be flying in a plane in 3 weeks' time, will you not secure that friendship? That's how you ought to do it. Secure your friendship with your husband. Be friends. Heart-to-heart friendship is a good one. Praise the Lord. I want to make my last reference from a pilot story. The pilot story is in the one that is in John chapter 19. Let me read it. John chapter 19 and verse 12. Pilate had the power to release Jesus. He had the power to execute Jesus when Jesus was going to die. And then Jesus told him, it is not as if you have the power. It is God that has given you that power. But I want you to see the importance of friendship. Pilate was not ready to give up friendship with the king, Caesar. He appreciated the friendship he had with Caesar. Even if he was going to execute somebody, as long as it pleased Caesar, I would do it. Let me read it briefly. John chapter 19 and verse 12. It says, and from henceforth, Pilate sought to release him. When Pilate finally saw that, this man has not really done anything. Why do you even want to kill him? Sought to release him, but the Jews cried out saying, if thou let this man go, thou art not Caesar's friend. Ooh. So, what is it you want to get from Caesar? Because he's a king. Because he has some benefits. Your husband, your wife, there are things that he has, even though you don't see it. Don't give up your friendship with him because of one thing or the other that has happened. He's the best man you can ever have. He's the best woman that you can ever have. Thank you so much and God bless you. Don't give up your friendship. Your friendship will take you to the next level. If Pilate was not ready to give up friendship with Caesar, don't give up your friendship with your wife. If she has done anything wrong, forgive her and move forward. If he has done anything wrong, forgive him and move forward. Let there be a bond, a gluing bond. Let the bond of Jesus come and dwell with you. You will be happy. You will be grateful. You will be glad. Let there be bond. Let there be friendship. When they say, I will not be your friend again even as a child. Don't you know how upset you are? And then you have a full-blood woman. A full woman with you. Treat him like a friend. Your family will be making progress. I keep saying it. There will be mind-blowing progress. Healing. Deliverance. You will not be running to hospital anyhow. Because your heart is beating well. Praise the Lord. And if you are not married yet, what a good chance you have. You are learning something today. Make friends with your husband that you'll be married to. Make friends with your wife that you'll be married to. You will scale her. You will be blossoming. You will be a reference point. People will say, don't you see them? How are they doing it? They are always together. How are they doing it? You are just being friends. And today, finally, on a final note, there's a friend that sticketh closer than anyone, and his name is Jesus. If you have not had Jesus in your life, you may struggle on how to be friends with another person. When you have Jesus in your heart, he teaches you how to go. He helps you to love your husband. He helps you to love your wife. He helps you to love your children. God bless you, sir. God bless you, ma. I appreciate you all. You will love your husband. He will teach you to love your husband. He will teach you to love your wife. Have you accepted Jesus today? Yes, no. If your answer is no, I encourage you today. I plead with you with the message of Jesus. Accept Jesus into your life today as your Lord and personal Savior. Your life will take a new turn. Life will be beautiful. Jesus wants to make life beautiful for you. Accept him today. Is the best thing you can do. Jesus loves you. He cares for you. He's interested in you. Love him like you have never done. And then he will bring your husband and your wife. Your home will be heaven on earth. You need to enjoy marriage here. If you get to heaven, you don't need marriage. Enjoy it. God has given it to you and I to enjoy here. Praise the Lord. I'm so glad you have all come. And for those who will be watching after this time, the Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. It's the first week, the first Sunday of February. This month will deliver goodies for us. This month will offer surprises for us. As we continue to make our husband and our wife, who are continual friends in the home, Jesus on the center of our friendship, we will continue to go up. Continue to go up, and thereby we will win more souls for Jesus. Lives will be turned to Jesus. Praise the Lord. The Lord bless everyone that has come today. The Lord keep you. The Lord will watch over you. The help and the grace of God will be multiplied upon you. You will not suffer shame. The glory of God will be revealed for you. If your home has been experiencing ups and downs, I decree by the mercies of God, your home will enjoy peace. Your home will enjoy peace in the name of Jesus. If there's anything you are desiring from the Lord Almighty, as you continue to walk in His ways, be friends with your husband, be friends with your wife, you will see a new song. You will sing a new song. There will be a change of story for your family in the name of Jesus. Thank you so much, everyone, for coming, and God bless you. I have my programs on a Sunday like this, United Kingdom, 4 p.m. Nigeria time, 5 p.m. United States is 11 a.m. Join me in my live broadcast next week, same time. As you do, we'll continue to see the grace of God being multiplied in our lives. And as we apply these principles, our lives will never remain the same again in the name of Jesus. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord will watch over you. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen.